is there or not. So there are many ways of doing it. Either you create your middleware. In the middleware, you decrypt the token and check if user ID is there and check the user ID in the database. We already have one method already created in the user service that checks if the email exists in the database or not. And user ID is nothing but the email in our system. Okay. Now what we will do is, first of all, we are getting this JWT. So first we have to register this JWT in the domain module, right? So there are different ways of registering it, like async initialization or synchronous initialization. So we can just simply use JWT module configuration. We can just check that in the documentation also, how to import it. So first of all, it should go into the module imports. I'll just copy and paste it from the template. This is, we don't need a config module. We are going to get everything from the process.env. Secret, I'll hot code this for now. Config service we don't need. JWT module we have to import. That can be imported. Config service dot expiration time. That also we'll add. Okay, so these are the two different environment variables we need. And that's enough. So this is how we are. So I will tell you the difference. Register async and let's see what all different methods it provides. Now there are different ways of module initialization. One is simple async, which is a dynamically invocation of a module, or there is a simple root async. If you already have the data available, which is in the process, but sometimes what you want is you wanted to initialize a module through a different module, then you needed this dynamic initialization, which we are doing here. Here we are calling register async and we are using this config service. This config service is first getting us all the key value pair and that we are passing inside a JWT module. So for that, if your module is dependent on another module during initialization process, then you will always use register async. It's not only for the JWT module, even for the database, we are doing the async initialization of type ORM module. So this is how we will introduce JWT module in our application. And then once you are doing the login, right? Once you are doing the login, we have to generate this token using JWT service. We have to sign the payload. Okay, so we can actually use JWT service once this is done. That's the problem with the live coding when you are doing things are slow. So I try to avoid it. I mean, I do all the installation first and then try to get things clear. Okay, I think we should be able to import now. Okay, this will be resolved once the installation is done. Now, once this is done, we will use authentication service. In the authentication service, we can write one method, okay, get user token, and we will have the payload for which we are going to generate the token, public async get user token. And what it will do is we will have a payload of type any for now, and this will have a user ID and our payload. JWT service we have to inject in the constructor of authentication service that we will import. Okay, that is coming from this JWT module only. Okay, so this is how we will generate the token. Now our method will call this, okay, and we will just generate the token. So we are doing a login in the controller. This is our user controller. Here we already got the user, so here we can actually call this method const token equal to this dot authentication service dot get auth user token, and we'll pass the user dot ID, which is a numeric, I think, and this is going to be async. Why it is complaining? This is returning with the token. This is async, so we can just use await. And